Hey guys, it's Brian back at you with another video where my goal is to mentor you to a rewarding career and to help you create a life you're proud of. And in that endeavor, today I'm going to be answering a question from one of the viewers out there. Guys, before I do, I just want to say thank you again for dropping by this channel. I know I've been not so good at making videos lately. The last post that I really had done was back in January, and now I'm doing more since I'm traveling and I'm able to. And I think part of that was really the struggle between the advice I've been getting from people that are good at YouTube, where they're saying that you should be posting, you know, twice a week, at least once a week. Whereas for me, I feel like a huge part of the value that I bring to you guys, and that really separates myself from everybody else, all the other coaches and mentors out there, is that, guys, I'm actually on the ground working, traveling, working for these bigger companies, really getting that perspective on the ground. And I see how things are changing with the times. I'm seeing the real dynamic. I'm using the things that I'm teaching all the time. And I think that that's really the value that I bring to you. Whereas others that might be coaching and mentoring, it's easy to read a book and regurgitate things in your own words and pass it on as legitimate advice. But at the same time, it's also very generic. Whereas when I'm working with you individually, when I'm making these videos, I'm coming from a different perspective that I believe provides real value. And as a result, because I am working so much, unfortunately, I'm not able to make the videos as often as I'd like. But trust me, I have a running list of topics. I have a running list of questions, and I'm trying to get to that the best I can. Okay, so let's quickly look at the question from someone named by Jessica Diaz, and she's asking, should I get another BA degree or my master's? Hi, I saw your video on your YouTube channel, and I actually am in this dilemma of doing another BA degree or not. I am a graduate in BA International Studies with Politics, and after I finished my degree, I got lost and ended up working in different low-paid jobs. I still haven't been able to get a job in the field I studied. It's very hard because I don't get help from anyone and I have to work to pay my bills. I couldn't afford to do any volunteer jobs. Please help me out. Any suggestions? I work in a medical practice at the moment as a medical admin, which is very low pay for a normal London job. Many thanks, Jessica. Thanks for the question, Jessica. I know that's a really good one, and there's a couple points that I really want to hit you on here. Number one, the first question you have is whether you should go back to school, right? Get a master's or get another BA. First question to you is, how much is that gonna cost you? And do you know what kind of job you want? Because it seems like you're just going after the major, thinking that if you get the education, you're gonna get the job. But you don't even know what job you want. And this is the same symptom that you had in your first degree. It looks like you didn't go after the job that you really wanted to, and you're settling for something that's low paying. I'm all for educating yourself. I'm all for getting more education so that you can get yourself a better job that makes you more money. But you need to know what that is first before you go and actually get a degree, because the last thing I want you to do is get into a student loan where you're more in debt now than you were before because you've got a degree and you don't even know if that degree is going to get you any value. So really spend the next 6 months tackling what your career is going to be, interview, meet people out in the field that is actually doing something that you're interested in, to get to understand what they're doing and actually get a sense of how much they're making. Yes, you can have coffee dates. You can ask them these questions, not necessarily about how much they're making, but how much someone in their position could make. And I think that's really gonna ground you before you start going out and investing in another degree that you don't even know is actually gonna provide any benefit to you. And chances are, if you go in that way, 99% of the time, you're not going to find a job that is gonna pay you the amount that you're gonna need to get out of debt, that's really gonna provide real value to you. And instead, you're gonna probably settle for something mediocre that isn't congruent with your ideals, with what you want. And as a result, you're gonna feel defeated, but this time with more debt. So guys and Jessica, be sure that you do your homework now. Go find out what you wanna do in the next 6 months while you're working in this lower paying job. Use this right now to really find out what you wanna do before you wanna tackle education again. Sounds like you're in a situation like many others, and it's not a good one, where after you graduate, you can't find the job that you want, and therefore you have to settle for a lower paying job. and it sucks because you do have bills to pay. You have to pay your rent, you gotta pay for your phone, you gotta pay for food, and you need money now. And as a result, you're taking a job on that isn't really congruent with your degree. And so there's that conflict internally, and I get that. And I think what you have to do and realize is that the job is just a J-O-B. It's only to get you by, right? It's not supposed to be your career. Now that said, what's really cool about this J-O-B is that it's a good experience. So while it's currently in the medical field, and you might think, okay, it's low paying, I challenge you to think of, okay, is it low paying for someone in your position? Maybe it's an entry level job. What about your boss? What about your boss's boss? What do the departments touch the position that you're in? And if there are other avenues to jump to another department that makes more money, or if that you see and notice that your boss or your boss's boss makes more money and considerably more, why aren't you tackling that? Why isn't that something that you want to strive for, right? That could be another avenue to really focus in on, an avenue of experience, of expertise. You might not get it today, but if it's something that you're going after, and then through that you create new networks, you create new relationships, or perhaps you realize you need more education, aha, now there's more purpose. And at the same time, you know that that's where the real money is. Maybe you know, based on the pay scale, that your boss is going to be making six figures, or your boss's boss is going to be making more six figures, and that's what you want, then go after that. See, the point that I'm making is that it's really easy for us to rule out our current situation and think that it is a dead end. But if you look around you, and it doesn't have to be that far off, you might realize really quickly that you have a lot of options that you just haven't explored. When you get out of college, you start an entry-level job, and you just look at yourself, and you think, in your entry-level job, I'm making 20 grand, 30 grand, and you know, I've been there, we've all been there. But the thing is, I didn't think that that's where I was gonna be for the rest of my life. I already knew there's gonna be something more. And so what did I look at? I looked at my superiors, I looked at my network, I looked at people around me to see, okay, well, what could that next look like? And if I didn't have that immediately, I could at least aim in terms of income what that next would look like. Okay, that person ahead of me in the other department is gonna be making 60 grand a year. I wanna tackle that. What's it gonna take to get over there? And my final point, and this is something that I hear a lot through my emails and through my comments, is about the need or desire to have a high paying job right after you graduate. Well, the reality is that you're not going to have a high paying job after you graduate, unless you guys are going to be a doctor, a lawyer, an engineer, like those type of degrees. Yes, of course, you're going to have a high paying job right off the bat, or at least a good chance of that, because you're studying in a field that requires a huge investment on your part, both in dollars and in time. There's an understanding, an establishment, and a market value that is associated with these types of degrees. But for the rest of you guys, including myself, which, you know, I don't have an engineering degree, I just have a regular bachelor's of science degree. Going into the field, you're not gonna be making that much money. And I want you guys to realize that off the bat. It's quite common, and I don't want you guys to feel discouraged thinking, oh, okay, then I didn't make that six-figure income going right out of school. And chances are you can't make that because you don't have the experience to command those types of dollars. So the reality is that you're not gonna be making a lot of money right now. But guys, if you do what I'm telling you, and you are tapping into that network and looking above and beyond, not just what you can bring on or how much money you can make or what your pay raise next year might be, but look at what your boss's boss or the boss's boss is doing, and looking at the departments around those people, and to see, okay, what are my options there, and how do I get there? What am I going to need education wise? What am I going to need networking wise? What am I going to need social skill wise to get there? So there you go, Jessica. I hope this helps you today. Guys, if you have a question for me that you'd like me to answer in a future video, go to my website, 101mentoring.com. Remember, I am here to make sure that you guys have a great start to your career after you graduate. And if you want, you guys can work with me personally, either through 101 mentoring or through email mentoring. I also have some other packages and ebooks that you guys can purchase, all on my website. Check it out. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you at the next one. Cheers.